It's time to unbox something again. What up guys, welcome back to another episode. My name is Eddie Bader and today we will take a shot at Drobo's direct attached storage called 5D3. And this device is actually one of the cheapest available Thunderbolt 3 storage devices you can get at the moment. One of the biggest advantages when it comes to the 5D3 is actually the fact that it comes without any pre-installed hard drives. So this means you can collect all the drives you have lying around at your home and you don't use anymore, shove them in there, and you're already good to go. You have a storage device that will get the best out of the drives you have lying around. But before we tear today's box apart, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also make sure to check out the fully written articles on eddie-bear.com. And there you will find all the benchmark values I took when I was testing the Drobo 5D3. So without further ado, let's get unboxing.
Okay, so it starts all with a box on top. In the box on top, we have more writings. This is actually a nice idea to promote the whole thing. We got some stickers, warranty stuff. We got the, let me change the angle for a bit. We got a PSU for the Drobo. So this is actually nice. Drobo is including international plugs for the power unit. And last but not least, we have our USB-C cable here. Okay, so now let's continue with the Drobo itself. And this is the Drobo unit. Additional merch. Let's turn it around and here we go. Okay, so this is the Drobo itself. Let's start at the back. This is the power plug, so pretty easy and basic. And of course, we have a power switch. With the huge fan on the back, I'm hoping that the Drobo 5D3 is quiet and it won't do too much of a noise. Okay, so let's talk about connectivity here for a moment. On the left, we have two USB-C type Thunderbolt 3 connectors, and those two are able to provide per port 40 gigabits. On the right, there is a USB-C USB 3.0 connector. And this one is only capable of 5 gigabits. I'm not entirely sure what's the deal with the feed of the Drobo, but this shouldn't be happening with a storage device. Especially if you have spinning parts in a storage device. The device has to be totally flat and it should not be able to physically move with little of force here. So this is a big negative point on the Drobo. Okay, so now let's take a look on the front of the Drobo. So this little lid here is mounted with some magnets here. So we get a nice little overview what the LEDs mean and what's the state of the storage device itself. So the setup on the Drobo is pretty easy and forthcoming, so you don't need much knowledge of storage devices in order to set this whole thing up. And actually, if you want to insert the drive, you just need to push it in here and you're already good to go. Here on the bottom we have additional LEDs that show us the actual storage consumption of our RAID system. With the Drobo 5D3, you're also able to speed up the read and write processes in your Drobo with the help of an SSD tier. The installation of the SSD tier is pretty forthcoming and easy. You just need to place it in here, push it in, put the lid back on, and here you go, you have now an SSD tier installed into your Drobo. And here is a heads up for the flash tier that you can install in the Drobo. Actually, the manufacturer is recommending a tier maxed out to 64 gigabytes. So good luck getting a 64 gigabytes SSD today.
because they are pretty much sold out. And I had a 1 terabyte installed in it, so it was a completely waste of money in there. So if you want to save some money on your storage configuration, this is a good point to save on. So I had really a hard time even looking for 128 gigabytes of SSDs. And sometimes the uplift for a 256 gigabyte SSD is slim to none. So decide for yourself how much you want to put in there. But as I said, 64 gigabytes is the max that actually Drobo is capable of utilizing effectively. To make my review more relatable, I also decided to give you an overview what kind of drives I was using. So I used for the whole test environment 3 1 terabyte drives that were spinning at 7,200 rounds per minute and were topping out around 130 megabytes per second in read and also in write performance. The Drobo 5D3 is focusing on customers that don't want to worry about settings or how to set something up, how to adjust something and whatnot. So they made the whole system pretty easy to use. And that's the same with the drives. You can install every hard drive without the use of additional tools. And the moment you install your first drive, you're almost good to go. And you actually can set up the Drobo with just one drive in its bay. But let me give you a quick rundown on the additional steps you need to take in order to get your storage device up and running. Getting your Drobo up and running is pretty easy. The only thing you need to do is to download the Drobo dashboard and the wizard will take care of the rest for you. At first, the wizard will try to update the firmware on the 5D3. Now it's time to format the drives to make them accessible for your computer. Since I'm using a Mac, only HFS Plus is available for me. In order to access my files on a Windows-based system on the Drobo, I will need to have some additional HFS Plus drivers in place. One thing I really didn't like about the Drobo 5D3 is the fact that it will always display 64 terabytes of usable storage if you check it on your computer. Once you are done formatting your drives, you can now access additional status information about the drives you actually installed in your Drobo. More to the performance values later in this review, but now let's take a look on how the Drobo actually handles storage. In this example, I have installed 2 1 terabyte drives in the Drobo, and in this case, it kind of works like a RAID 1, so this means I can use half of the usable storage of the 2 drives combined. But what happens if I decide to extend this storage by, let's say, 1 extra drive? Now the magic of the Drobo 5D3 kicks in. So this means it does not care how big your drive is or what kind of drives you shove in it. It will automatically extend the RAID over all the drives that are actually installed. The cool thing about the Drobo RAID system is that it will give you more usable space than the legacy RAID styles you know from other vendors. With most of the storage systems available today, you have to choose a certain RAID level for your whole storage system. But with the Drobo, it's something different. They use a proprietary RAID level that actually decides on itself how it manages the data on the dedicated drives. So let's see what happens if a drive actually fails on you or you decide to remove it and replace it with another drive. Well, actually nothing. The Drobo will automatically start to reorganize the data on the storage device, and with this it will lower the chances for data loss. You actually even can increase the safety of your files. If you have 3 drives or more installed, you can activate the double fault tolerance in the settings. When it comes to the performance values of the 5D3, my readings were actually quite volatile. I got write speeds around 200 and 400 megabytes per second, and read topped out somewhere around 180 megabytes per second. And this actually is rather good for 3 actual drives installed in it, and with the additional SSD tier. But let's take a look on how actually the Drobo 5D3 performed under real life conditions.
If you take a look on the photocopy test, it is actually impressive how huge the impact of the SSD tier is. The moment it comes to huge individual files, the SSD tier unfortunately isn't able to compensate as much.
With the copy test, we actually learn a lot of the flash capabilities of the Drobo 5D3. So with smaller sized files like photos, we get up to 50% increase in write speed and 40% in read speed. With bigger sized files like video files, it is not as huge as with photos, but it's still 20% with write speed and almost 10% to read speed. And naturally, I also tested for rendering time improvement. So a 14-minute 4K video rendered in Final Cut Pro on the Drobo 5D3 took me about 17 minutes to render all the way out. And it actually didn't make too much of a difference whether there was an SSD tier installed or not. Since the Drobo 5D3 is not actually just a shelf where you can shove your drives into, it is also a storage device with some intelligence in it and also some additional features. So let's talk about those for a minute. One of the coolest things with the Drobo is actually the fact that it comes with a USB. So this means if you have a power failure, your Drobo actually will not just cut out and you lose the data that is actually written at the moment. So if you unplug your cord for, let's say, test purposes, then you will see what happens. In the case of such an unfortunate event, the Drobo will not hit rock bottom. It will start to write down its data onto a flash memory that is actually installed in the Drobo. And when it's done, it will automatically turn itself off. The next time you power it on, it will then write the data back onto your storage. And hopefully, if everything goes well, then you won't have any kind of data loss. But still, if you live in an area where you are facing regular power outages, it will not replace a proper USB. Another cool thing is how the Drobo is handling your drives. So you always can remove the installed drives as hot plug drives. So this means you don't need to turn off the device in order to remove or add another drive. And the Drobo will always take care of the arrangement of the data that is stored on these drives. But make sure if you remove a drive or install a new one, let the Drobo finish its magic and don't tinker around with it while it is doing so, because sometimes reorganizing this data can take a lot of time. So let's do its thing. Wait till it's done and then you're already good to go back on the road. The Drobo is actually a really nifty device, but it also has some downsides to it. As you've seen in the beginning of this video, my device turned out to be not completely flat, and this means it kinda was able to move around, and with a component that has moving parts in it, movement is actually not really a good thing. So I'm not sure whether my device was faulty on this part. The moment not all the feet are facing the bottom of the floor or on whatever you are placing your storage device on, it can introduce unwanted vibrations. And this, in my case, led to a horrible loud device. So take a look for yourself. So as you see, this noise was so annoying and it actually drove me completely nuts. So if you are working in a silent environment, I'm not sure whether the Drobo is actually the right device for you. With all the benchmarks taken and all the data analyzed, I give the Drobo 5D3 in my YouTube Storage Guide 2018 a whooping score of 4,490 points. And let me give you a quick rundown why it is achieving this score. The Drobo 5D3 makes it really easy for creative professionals to get into a lower segment of storage devices. It makes it easy for them to configure them. They don't need to know all the settings and all the things they can do with a storage device. And the most important thing, it's the cheapest storage device that offers this amount of speed that you can get for this amount of money. So with that said, the Drobo actually is able to perform really well in 4K editing, and you will definitely notice the difference if you have a huge photo database. So if you are a photographer, a storage device like the Drobo will help you in your daily workflow, and it will always be faster than a network attached storage. So always keep in mind, a network attached storage will only deliver around 100 to 120 megabytes per second through a 1 gigabit connection. And since most of the photographers and videographers don't have a 10 gigabit Ethernet connection at their home, a direct attached storage will always be outperform a network attached one. The performance in the Drobo 5D3 is actually pretty limited, so it will top out somewhere around 530 megabytes per second. So no matter if you're using helium-based high capacity drives that give you somewhere around 240 megabytes per second or SSDs, you will not get the full potential out of those drives if you place them all in your Drobo. If you want to utilize the power in those drives, you will have to go for a higher price device, but maybe I'll look into one of those in my later reviews. So what do you think about the Drobo 5D3? Is it actually a device you would consider for your home office or maybe for semi-professional work? Or are you even one of the few people that are already owning a Drobo 5D3? Hit me up in the comments and tell me what you think about today's review. And as I mentioned before, if you want to take a look at all my test results, make sure to check them out on eddie-bear.com in the blog. And with that said, thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time.